Thank you very much, and a very good evening to you. Welcome once again to Jukebox Jury. And over the last week, the music business has been working very hard, churning out new releases. And we hope that we've got a very interesting selection of new releases for a very interesting panel. The first juror is a gentleman who used to be with a very famous band, the Sex Pistols, and is now with Public Image Limited, Johnny Rotten. And last Saturday night, I spent a very pleasant evening in the company of the next juror. She didn't know I was there, but I finally got round to see Evita. She's got a record out this week called EP, Sings EP. One's Eva Peron, and the other is Elaine Page. And try this one for a puzzle. He left Australia back in 1952. Since then, he's given pleasure to millions. He is an Australian. He's not Kerry Packer. He used to say, greetings, pot pickers, Alan Freeman. And the next introduction's a little bit difficult because I'm not really supposed to say bitch on the BBC, but that's the name of the film that comes out in September, and it's a very warm welcome to actress Joan Collins. So, that's the jury, and this is record number one. What do you reckon, Alan? Hit or a miss?
Who, me?
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Too busy playing with Elaine. Caught you there.
Yes. I've always thought of Shiwadi Wadi as being rather fun, being rather extrovert, and as a matter of fact, almost being comical. I think that this is a, to my way of thinking, to my way of feeling, this is a more serious attempt at record making from them. I think it says nothing new. But I think it's an interesting record, and I think that with their ambiance and with what's gone before, I think that this could possibly get back into the charts for them. I think it's a nice, pleasant record.
Thank you, Alan. Joan.
Well, to me, it doesn't seem to be terribly modern. I mean, it doesn't seem to have any specific newness about it. It's a bit repetitive. It sounds a bit like many, many songs that I've heard before. I like the group. I think the group is good, but. You didn't finish it, did you? You only played about a minute and a half. It leaves me a bit in the middle.
Johnny Rotten.
Rubbish. And the audience agrees, so it's a miss all round.
Elaine?
Oh, what can I say? Actually, I think that it's it is rather like something that you've heard before. I think I'm going to agree with Johnny. I think it's a miss.
Sensible girl.
Well, they're the opinions. Can we have the verdict, actually, if you'd like to show us whether you think it will be a hit or a miss? And that's the first one for Shiwadi. Remember, then didn't make it to the 20. They don't think that one's going to make it at all. And here is record number two.
Mm-hmm.
that's Donna Summer. Out of 14 releases, some 13 or so have made the top 50. I wonder about that one. A new single, Bad Girls, Joan Collins.
I just love Donna Summer. I think she is just about the top, for me, the top lady singer around today. I think I played her records into the ground. I've worn them out and bought other ones. And I think this one, I don't know about all the beeps at the beginning. She's obviously trying to get away from her sort of sexy image. I like the Latin American beat that she has there. And I think because of who she is, I don't think it's as good as some of the things that she's done previously, but I think because of the fact that she is such a tremendous star and a tremendous singer, I think it's probably going to do very well. And I love it.
Are you a dancer? I mean, do you actually dance for pleasure?
I'm a dancer, a disco dancer, yeah. I tramp around a bit.
Thank you, Joan. Johnny Rotten.
God, that ain't the Donna Summers, I know. I hate it. It's awful.
Where do you think she's changed?
It was mediocre. Full stop.
But if it's not the Donna Summer that you knew...
No, I mean, come on, I don't deserve no more comment than that.
Thank you. Elaine?
Well, like Joan, I'm a real Donna Summer fan. I love and have loved nearly everything she's ever done. I really don't feel this is up to her usual standard. The rhythm and all that's there. I mean, maybe it's good if it's loud and it's good to bop to, but actually with actual song content, I don't think it's as good as it could be.
Thank you, Elaine. Alan?
I have a funny feeling of late that a lot of very worthwhile talents, and I think Donna Summer is one, are actually sacrificing their talent in order to be in vogue and make disco records. You see, I think Donna Summer has a voice that in fact can give us far more than we get from making continual disco records. That's only my opinion. And I think that I think we're oversaturated with disco. I know it's lovely to go into a disco and dance and feel the beat and feel the rhythm, but I think we're being pulverized by it. I think it should stop. And I think that it's time we found something very, very different that is popular. I don't think it's a hit.
Right. Okay, so it's a little bit mixed. There's a couple of thumbs down quite definitely. Can I ask you, please, now to tell us whether you think it will be a hit or a miss? Two misses? Three misses?
Well, it depends, doesn't it? It's going to be a hit anyway.
Well, it's still... That, nice observation from Johnny. It'll be a hit anyway. It is a miss as far as we are concerned. We have some public opinion for you. Once again, Adrian has been out and about grabbing people when they were least expecting it and asking them about new records. That's ABBA and Angel Eyes. They've had five number ones, but they haven't had one at the top since 1978. I wonder what'll happen to that one. Johnny Rotten.
Nothing. It's horrible. I mean, look, it's like they knew beforehand the BBC had picked it for this programme. You know what I mean? It's like nice and weedy.
What sort of music do you personally enjoy?
Decent.
Could you maybe give us an example of what you think's decent?
Well, my own stuff for a start.
But I once heard you in an interview saying that one of the things you detested most about the new wave music was that nobody was taking it seriously, but so far you don't seem to have said very much in terms of well-balanced criticism. I just wonder whether you might
I don't get involved in lecturing. I just do it. I don't over-promote. You either like or dislike what I do. I won't ram it down your throats like what happened in the past.
Elaine Clayton.
I don't know, I'm uncertain about this one. Evidently, as far as I know, they're coming over here in November to do some concerts.
Do you think they've fallen into the trap of sort of make it more like a hit machine?
I think they have. I think that's really what Johnny was saying, is that they're sort of just banging things out now because they've found a formula that seems to work, and so stick with that because we know it works.
Right.
I don't know about this one, I'm not sure.
Alan?
Me? Well, I'm very inclined to agree with Johnny and Elaine on this particular issue. I think they were when they won the Eurovision Song Contest with Waterloo, I thought they were very inventive and rather sensational, and I think their first five or six singles that followed were also quite innovative and rather inventive. And of course, all of a sudden they've become some of the biggest, or one of the biggest selling groups in the world, make a lot of money, and I think they've lost their invention.
It had a strange sort of military beat. It had a sort of, almost like, kind of Grease overtones, to me. I don't think it's nearly up to their usual standard, and I didn't like it as much as most of the stuff they've done. I really didn't.
Right, well, they all seem quite clear of the fact that ABBA's not really up to it. We went out and about to ask a few members of the public what they thought. I mean, Adrian grabs you. Well, he really does grab you.
Hello. Thank you for volunteering.
Volunteering? I was dragged out of the apartment.
Like that record?
I thought it was pretty boring, really.
Too much background. It's not very good in the front. It's singing's not very good.
Smart, isn't it? Decent.
You like that type of music?
Yeah, it's sort of a change for the old funky sort of music, isn't it?
Sort of bopped along reasonably well, I suppose.
I enjoyed it, actually. It'll be in the top 10. I don't know. The last one didn't, did it? Do you know where the last one got to?
I don't think it was top 10.
No, I think it was in the top 5. But I think ABBA's in the top 10 anyway, of some description. But not quite make number 1.
Hello.
Hello.
What did you think of that record?
All right.
Was it only all right? Isn't it very all right?
No.
It makes you wonder who's buying ABBA's records. Okay, is it going to be a hit or a miss? Could we have the official verdict there? Well, that's enough. It is coming that way. Interesting turnabout at the end from Mr. Rotten. And now we move on to yet another new record, and don't forget that we'll be asking a few people a few more views in a while. But here's the next one. Thank you. Oh, produced by Ron and Russell Mayle of Sparks. That's Adrian Munsey and Say Sheep. And Elaine, what did you think of that?
Well, this is a new one on me. I haven't heard of this person before, these people, however many of them are there. I don't know quite what to say of this. I mean, it sounds like someone's in the bathroom pulling strings and things, lots of burps and burps, and I don't quite know.
They were sheep.
Oh, is that what it is?
Yes, you've sort of got some sheep singing.
Oh, well, they've accomplished their mission then. That's exactly what it sounded like, didn't it? Again, it's something, you know, it's, what is it? I've heard it before, and there aren't even any words. No, I don't know. This is just the same thing.
I like it.
Thing.
It's nonplussed you completely.
Exactly. It's just nowhere for
Alan.
Me.
Well, actually, when we used to shear sheep in Australia, we never used to make noises like that at all. Is it a television theme or a... seriously, or a theme for a show on television or a theme for something? I mean, because it's repetitive and it goes nowhere and it doesn't start, and I hate it.
Fair enough. Adrian Munsey appears to be getting a thumbs down at the moment. Joan, what did you think?
Well, I think if you were at a disco and you were drunk enough, you'd get up on the floor and you'd probably prance around to it. If it was played loud enough. There was a bit of celestial choir in there, wasn't there? Somewhere, mixed in among the baaing and the lambs and the shepherds. Nothing.
Fair enough.
Nothing.
Johnny?
Oh, God. That's just Virgin Records out to make a quick buck and failing really badly. That's all I can say.
Oh, I don't think he liked it. So... Would you like to tell us officially your verdict, a hit or a miss? Oh, there we go. That's another one of those for Say Sheep, which is a terrible shame because we have got with us the sheep.
Hello.
That's Loopy Lou.
Yeah.
Well, Loopy Lou has the right of reply. There we go. The right of reply. It was a... Yeah. Lovely. Well, thank you very much indeed, Loopy Lou, for coming along. Yes. Oh, dear. Now we move on to the next record. Susie and the Banshees and Playground Twist, Alan.
Yeah, I've played a lot of records by Susie and the Banshees. I think she's a very revolutionary singer. Funnily enough, when I heard her then, I started thinking of Julie Driscoll. She has similar tones, she has similar delivery to Julie Driscoll. I mean, she's considered a little flamboyant, I know that. But funnily enough, I think her singing has tremendous merits. I don't particularly hear that as a hit record, but I think Susie and the Banshees will be around for a long time, and I think she has a lot of talent, Susie particularly.
Thank you, Alan. Joan?
I was trying to listen to the words. What is she getting down on her knees for? I get on here. What is the theme of the song? Is what I was trying to get what she was trying to say. I quite like the sort of stirring, revolutionary type of sound. I think it's something that I think the kids will like it, actually. It's not particularly my type of thing. Kids don't like it. It's not particularly my kind of thing, but I have a feeling that it's going to do well. I don't know why, I just feel that.
Thank you. Johnny Rotten.
What do you lot say? Mixed opinion.
Would you care to add yours?
Next one, please.
Elaine?
I liked it, actually. It sort of has a kind of dramatic, kind of stirring feeling about it. I think it's exciting. I like it.
Right, Susie and the Banshees, are they onto a hit or a miss, would you say? Well, that one's away. Mr. Rotten. Right down the middle, but it can't stop that being a hit in the eyes of the panel. We have another new release coming up. We also have a few comments from some people that we well and truly bumped into. Monks and I ain't getting any. Unquote.
Getting any what? What isn't he getting any of? Oh, I see. Yes. Well, it has a modern sound. I think it has a modern beat. Certainly a modern singer. I wouldn't play it, nor would I buy it, but I have a feeling that it would probably be a hit.
Johnny?
Well, normally I wouldn't listen to it. It's patronising, rubbish. Yeah. God, they're all so bad, these records.
And they gave us a list beforehand.
Elaine?
Well, what can I say? This is a long way from the Straubs, that's right, isn't it? But the Hudson Ford from the Straubs. It's so different, I can't believe it. But I don't know, as Joan said, it's sort of the modern kind of punchy sound. Maybe it will do something. I don't exactly like the lyric particularly either.
Australia's expert on the subject, Alan?
Well, actually, I was surprised that Johnny didn't make any comment about this record, because very early in the Sex Pistols career, he delivered the same kind of thing.
Yes, 4 years ago. Big
yes,
difference.
That's fine. Four years ago, that's fine, John. And I'm quite sure that you're very proud of what you did 4 years ago. And I'm sure that these boys are equally as proud as what they've done here in 1979. So you can't criticise them from that particular angle.
I think I don't like to be patronised, and that's what that record reeks.
Shut
of.
Up, will you?
No, I won't. I think, one of the great
pities on this particular record.
It's rubbish, full stop. Rubbish. Miss.
Is the fact, that records aren't played in full sometimes on Jukebox Jury, which allows you more time to get into them. From what I heard there is promise, and I think there could be a happening. I like it.
Thank you, Alan. I should let you go on. I think you have a fine political career in front of you. Handling heckling could be quite a forte of yours. Here we have a chance for Adrian to handle some members of the public.
Oh, lots of things. It's better than ABBA anyway.
Very nice. Probably make the top 20. I couldn't tell you how high it will go, but it's got a good catchy tune to it, mm-hmm. and I like it.
What would you do with it if I gave it to you?
Give it to me, sister.
Don't you like it?
Ace.
I think monks are cool. We're as good as the Pistols.
Nothing to write home about?
Not really, I live here.
I think it's just an average record, you know, I don't think it's anything outstanding.
The monks, I ain't getting any. I hate saying the title. Do you think it'll be a hit or a miss, jury? Oh, yeah, they reckon it's going to be...
Can you see that bit there?
One of those, which is a great relief because the monks are here.
Oh. Ah, yeah.
Any of you get us a beer, Carson?
You want a beer?
Do you want some?
Oh, nice to meet me.
Yeah.
We didn't know you were there.
It's not a party. It's not a... Oh, while they're having a party, it's record number 7. That's Dominic Troiano and a new single, We All Need Love. We haven't got time for any comments on it, but could I please ask you, just on that very brief play, whether you'll stick your necks out and tell me whether you think it'll be a hit or a miss?
Hit.
Yeah. A hit?
Love it.
Which means, by making a note down here on this chart, I can compare the opinions of the jury here tonight with BBC local radio stations around the country. Radio Medway, Radio London, BBC Radio Bristol, Radio Leicester, and Radio Newcastle played those new releases to listeners to their radio stations in the week. So if we now have a look at our chart, we can see exactly how those opinions compare with the opinions of the jury. And if we go to the top, Shawadi Wadi, as far as our jury, a miss. Local radio said a hit, so a bit inconclusive there. Donna Summer, a miss, and a hit as far as local radio listeners concerned. ABBA, a miss for our jury. And all 5 local radio stations said it would be a hit. Adrian Munsey with his sheep, a miss here, and very much a miss as far as local radio is concerned. Well and truly. Susie and the Banshees, a hit. Here with our jury, only one radio station. Radio Bristol thought it would be a hit. The others thought it would be a miss. The monks, I ain't getting any. That was a hit here. And local radio listeners said... Very much a hit. And finally, Dominic Troiano, a hit. And as far as local radio was concerned, also a hit. So it'll be interesting over the next few weeks to see how much the local radio listeners disagree with our jury here. I think it's proved too much for Alan Freeman, certainly. I hope Joan Collins and Elaine enjoyed themselves.
We're not talking about listeners.
And I hope it wasn't too exciting for Johnny Rotten, who seems to have taken the whole thing.
Good night.
He's gone off to a previous engagement. For this edition of Jukebox Jury, good night.